So today we're going to be talking about filters. So there's three types that we use in Lightroom: radial filters, gradient filters, and then there's a brush filter. I use these techniques to amplify an image or give it direction. By that I mean, if for example an image has a subject that I want to pay more closer attention to, I try to manipulate the image in a way that when the viewer looks at the image, they are directed straight to the subject that I want them to look at, instead of their eyes wandering everywhere and thinking where to look. This is a good technique when you want to emphasize a subject. For example, you want to give them more importance in the frame, or sometimes it can also help in accentuating certain characteristics of the picture. For example, there's light coming in through one direction and then you can accentuate that light. Or you can darken some parts of the photo so the attention doesn't go there, or you want to hide some extra detail, for example, some lines or something that's not really important to the image. You can darken that area out so that the eyes don't usually float there. It's also similar to vignetting. However, vignetting affects the whole image, but by doing it separately in different corners or different sides of the photo, you can control where the viewer's eye is looking at. Anyway, talk is cheap, so let's get into it and I'll show you what I'm talking about. All right, jumping into Lightroom, I have selected four images that I can use to show you the filters. In the first image, I have a photo of a watch. Let's go into the develop module. So here, I'll show you the before and the after. Clearly, I have edited the photo in terms of basic correction, white balance and all that. In this example, I'm going to show you what a radial filter does. So in the top right here, you'll see this circle right next to this long brush. And when you keep your cursor over there, it shows you that this is the radial filter. Click. And you can see that I already placed a radial filter on this image, right on the face of the watch. This filter here kind of constrains the edit to anything inside this circle or outside of it. So I'll explain in a sec. So when I use this filter here, I used it to accentuate or draw the focus of the viewer to the watch to make it pop out. So when I turn off the filter, you can see that the filter kind of looks dull, doesn't look bright. The tonality of the watch kind of blends in with the rest of the photo. However, when I turn it on, you can see that it pops out. So you can kind of focus on it more as opposed to the rest of the image. So let's start from the beginning. I'll delete it. So you go up here, radial filter, you draw one around the watch like so. And like I said before, you can constrain the edit or the edits within the circle. However, you need to click invert right here to do that. I press O on the keyboard to show you what's being masked. So anything in red is the thing being masked, and anything that's not red is being left alone. So when we click invert at the bottom right here, this shows that we're masking out whatever is inside this ellipse, which is the watch. Press O again to get rid of the red, and that's just the mask overlay that shows you what's being edited. And you can turn that on by going down here at the bottom, or you can click or press O on the keyboard. So the first thing I did was bump up the exposure a little bit, make it more brighter, bump up the contrast a little bit, bring up the highlights, bring down the shadows to give it extra contrast, bring up the whites because the face is white, and bring down the black just by a little bit to give it extra contrast. And what I did here was, since the watch is yellow, gold, I went up here to temperature and just warmed it up just a tiny bit to make it more shiny, more yellowy, goldy looking. You can either bump up the saturation a little bit so it stands out more, or you can leave it how it is. Sharpness, you can make it a tad bit sharp, so it's sharper than the rest of the photo. And if there was any noise, I can denoise it. However, this looks fine. So when you click done, you can see that, there you go, the radial filter has made the watch pop out more as compared to the background. And if you want to see how it looks like without it, little switch here, off, on, massive difference, right? So now moving on to the next image here, I have an image of a rainforest, a walkway in a rainforest. When we look at this image, I kind of try to look at the overall image and see what I need to make more prominent or the details I need to hide. So over here I have the light coming down from this opening, and then I have darkness at the bottom and the top. So I have used a vignette here. When we get rid of that, you can see that the top is a bit more brighter and even the bottom here. However, the bottom here kind of is distracting. These rocks aren't really adding to the photo and I would like to hide them. So when you add a vignette, it affects the overall image. So see how it's darkening everything, even from the sides and the bottom and the top. But in this case, I want to just darken the bottom, get rid of the distracting rocks here. And I want to keep the light at the top shining down so it looks more, I don't know, angelic. So top right again, next to the radial filter on the left, it says graduated filter. Sometimes I call it gradient filter because it has a gradient. So click that. What you do is you drag in whatever direction you want to. So I'll drag it from the bottom to the top. I'll press O on the keyboard to show you what I'm masking. So this is the basically the masking center, or like this is where the masking is more prominent or intense. And then the second line here is basically the blending or feathering of that mask. So if you stretch it out, it feathers it out more. Bring it down, there's less feathering. So I'll have a bit of feathering, so it looks like a nice gradient from dark to light. Get rid of the gradient mask. And so let's go here, bring down the exposure. See, by bringing it down, I'm only affecting the bottom here. I'm not affecting the top or anything. So this is bringing the viewer's eye straight towards the walkway and that platform over there. And what I can also do is add another one from the right. See all this bush over here, the greenery, it's kind of distracting, kind of making your eye move towards the right. So I'll bring a filter here, make it straight like this. So you can move the filter left, right, as in like you can rotate it, you can move it by holding the middle button. Bring down exposure. Bring it up here. Bring it back. Like that. Done. And now you can see, when I go back here, it's not a big difference. However, it does hide the details which are not important to the photo and guides your eye more towards the left side of the photo, so this platform, and helps the viewer look towards the main attraction, which is this platform and the light coming down. So going into the third photo here, photo of a building, clearly you can see that this building seems more yellow than the one at the back here. This is actually supposed to be blue. So what I can do two things. I can either go up and change the temperature of the photo, but you see that it's affecting the whole photo and I don't want that because I want the ground to look neutral and natural. So I can do either the radial filter and draw a circle around here, bring down the temperature. Sorry, forgot to invert it. There you go. It gives you that haloing effect though. So around the building, you'll see like the blue is bleeding out. You can limit it like this. However, there's another option, which is the brush filter. So adjustment brush, it's called here. You click that and you get a brush head. So you can press O, you can see where you're coloring, which is really effective. You can make the head bigger, smaller, and the second circle around the middle one is basically the feathering area. So what I can do here is color in the building, get rid of the mask overlay, bring down the temperature, which is much more natural as opposed to the radial filter with that haloing effect. So now I want to move on to the next photo here, where I can show you the use of all three filters and show you how I can change the look of a photo and make it easier for the viewer to be guided through the photo. So firstly, we can see here that the sky is really bright. What I can do here, bring down the graduated filter, keep calling it gradient, bring down the exposure like so, not too much so it doesn't look unnatural, bring it down just a bit more. Then what I can do is also down here, the graduated filter, I don't want the viewer to be looking at this handrail because it's distracting and also pretty ugly. Bring down the exposure here, not too much so it doesn't look unnatural. Let's feather it out a little bit more, like so. Done. Get the radial filter, draw it around the city, like so. Let's make it a bit wider. So what I can do here, invert, change, make it a bit more yellow, warm, so it stands out, a bit more exposure, a bit more contrast, bring down the highlights, like so. Bring down the shadows to make it more contrasted. Bring up the whites, actually, you know what? Just leave them how they are. Bring down the blacks just by a tiny bit. And now you can see off, on, off, on. It looks more distinct than the rest of the image. We can make it bigger, cover more of the area. Maybe bring up the exposure a bit more. The point is just to bring the attention towards the city as opposed to, let's say, this scope or the sky. And what we can do is with the brush, you can brush out the scope if you want to see the overlay here. Make this a bit darker because that's not our focus. Get the crop tool. So if you're posting this to Instagram, 4x5, press X, auto straighten. So what we can do is bring it in like this. And now you can see the city here. And as you can see, before, after, before, after. And if you want a bit of vignetting, focuses on the city now. And there you go. That's the three filters. And before I finish, there's another trick of doing a vignette. You can make a circle here, but without pressing invert this time, we bring the exposure down. So it brings down the exposure of the whole image. Instead of bringing the exposure down, let's bring the highlights down, just like that. So, click done. Now you can see that the city is popping out of the image and that's where our focus is usually going to. And that's about it. So those are the three filters. In summary, radial filters, you can emphasize the subject within the round sphere or ellipse. The gradient filters or graduated filters, they have a gradient going across. And finally, the brush filters, which you can use to lighten or darken specific spots in the image, like dodging and burning. Hope this video was informative and of value, and hopefully I'll see you in the next one.